The language you are speaking now, this Jagaga you think that he's just speaking, is not a language for this time. God took from the ending. There is another, I'm saying this, another dispensation that is to come in the heavens, where we are all going to ascend to go. God took of the language of that realm and brought it to us now. Let me show you a scripture. Let's do Hebrews chapter 6 from verse 5. Remember, we still go back to Revelation 1:8. 6. Let's read, everybody. And have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world. So there is a world to come, and in that world there are levels of powers. God has given us to taste of that powers now. Prophecy is part of the powers your soul will carry in the world to come. Then it will no longer be a gift, it will be a nature. Are you following me? What we know as the gifts of the spirit, they will end in this age. Are you aware of that? Give me another version of 6:5, then we will journey again. Tonight I will just be journeying. The road is far. He said, and I've tasted the good word of God and the powers of the age. The name of that age is known as the Omega. It is the second dimension of the Father. It is in that age most of us will not have physical forms like this. You know, now you need to walk, to move. In that age, you will no longer be of this form. Are you aware of this? One more scripture. I'm saying the things we exercise now as power, in that age, it will be what? Nature. The way you can say, your name is Onyedikachi. Say the Holy Ghost, at that point, the Holy Ghost will not need to tell you, you will know. In that age, there is no, who are you? We shall all know as we are known. We wait for the Omega days. They are coming, where sickness and death will no longer be a part of that ecosystem. Are you hearing me? One more scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. I will follow the lion. I will follow the lamb. Wherever he goes, let's go. Let's do chapter 8. 1 Corinthians 13, 8. Let's try. Love never, whether there be prophecies, they shall be done away. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall be done away. Verse number 9. 9. The next verse. For we know in part, we give me another, maybe NIV. Let's try them. Still relevant, but let's try. Okay, KJV say we know in part, we present in part. Let's try something else. Okay, the same thing basically. Let's do verse number 10 now. For when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. There is it. So God is saying all this, there is someone here is still imperfect. It's not the will of God. The best of our manifestations are imperfect. Even if I can sit you down and tell you your life from day one to day, he says it's what? It's imperfect. All this anointing is still in the beginning. There is a dimension known as the Omega, the ending. So if what we are seeing now is not the fullness of the Holy Spirit yet, what we define as favor is still imperfect. The best of whatever expression we have now of God is still what? Is still imperfect. So John began to write and says in the beginning. So everything we have now, the two dispensations is that in everything we are doing now is actually what should I call it, rehearsals. Is what? Is rehearsals. Your knowing of God is still what? Is still the answer. Because the aim of God is not to have a teacher teach you. At the Omega, the Lord himself shall be the teacher. What? Are you following me now? Timo, here? You know, here what we have is that we have me now. I'm the apostle over this commission. I will be teaching you, bringing the word of God. When Omega shall come, all of us will sit down and Omega shall be our teacher. Do you know that? Let me show you Isaiah. Okay, let's help me with 11. Go to 11. We'll do 11 and 12. 11 and 12. 11 first before 13. That's 10. Now 11 is the next one. When I was a child, up to now, we are in the eyes of God, we are still what? Children. 70 years in faith, you are still a what? Child. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Verse number 12. Now we see. So, the eyes of the Lord, for those of us who are, what should I call it now? Prophetic. He said, now we see, but a what? A poor, the best of our sight is a what? A poor. Have you ever taken a picture with a old telephone, all these ancient telephones, that you all you can see is your teeth that is shining there. That's why your body is dark. So that level of darkness, it is the sharpest of our prophets. That's the best they can see God. The best we know of God is still dark. He said, but when, he says, it is a poor reflection as in a mirror. He said, then at the Omega of all time, we shall see what? Only one man had the ability to access this dimension before time. His name was Moses. Because when God talked, he said, Moses, he says, are you not afraid? You people are still in the beginning. I talk to you in the dreams, in visions. But Moses, we talk face to face. Are you hearing me? That's why in Luke chapter 16, I think so, Jesus went to the mountain of transfiguration to show the people how Omega shall look like. And as he sat down, the Bible says they came to him face to face. Wouldn't it be nice? Hear me now. Hear me. Imagine that depth of your walk in the spirit, that you don't hear a voice talking to you. It is the Lord himself that walks up and speaks to you about a person. He says, until you enter that dimension, what you are still seeing, what is still a poor reflection. Somebody say Jesus. The reason why you did not see him now is because you are still in the beginning. At the Omega of time, when you say Jesus, he shall appear. Remember Luke chapter 22 28, while they were walking on the road to Emmaus, they were talking about Jesus, and what happened? He came amongst them and began. I'm telling you what scripture offers us. So when John says that which was from the beginning, all we have, all the revelations we have of God is still in a dispensation known as the beginning. There is a second realm that is coming, and once in a while, so that God will show you the reality of that realm, he takes your spirit to a journey. Have you ever had a dream? And in the dream, you realize that you were not as weak as you were in the natural. God is showing you what is happening, what will happen at Omega. Are you hearing me? Okay, you have left my scripture. Say, okay, in King James, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, 12 says, for now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. That when you talk about angels, say, you will not need to talk once, that with the people you are talking to will come and appear. Say, okay, here we are. Say, Michael, he's there. Until these things become a reality, we are still in what? We are still in the Alpha of God. Everything we have seen for the last, from the beginning of time, is God still showing us his beginning. The second will be the Omega. Let's go back to our Revelation chapter 1 from verse 8. You split the sea so I can walk right through it. Revelation 1:8. I am Yah. I am Alpha Omega, the beginning and the ending, saith the Lord, which is, which was, and which is to come. Are you following me? So when, you know, it was the same John that wrote Revelations. Are you getting my point? So my question is, what did John, what happened to John? To the point that John was, you know, we showed from James, Peter, and Paul. Each of them wrote by knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. John wrote by revelation. There's a difference between knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, which you should have. But superior above all of them is what? It's revelation. Are you learning something? So, like, can we go back to our first John chapter 1 from verse 1, right? Are you learning something? Once in a while when you are praying, because he showed us in Hebrews 6:5 that we can taste of the powers of the world to come, right? We can what? We can what? Taste. We may not eat, but we can what? We can taste. Test it. Say, test and see that the Lord is good. So can I ask you a question? Do you know why when the anointing enters the church, you're under the anointing, you are falling or you are shaking? It's because your body is responding to the body it will carry in the world to come. Your mortality is not yet framed to carry such dimensions of power. And once in a while, Jesus will carry your tabernacle and place it up. Are you hearing me? Oh, do you know that there is a physical man and there is a spiritual man? Do you know that the moment you... Can I talk? You are not. Can I talk? Are you on WhatsApp? On the Bible, okay. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Do you know that the moment you say yes, Jesus, let me tell you what happens. I should tell you.